Good morning. We are glad that you are here this morning.
Buenos días, nos alegra de que estén aquí esta mañana.
And we want to begin our service of thanksgiving.
Queremos iniciar este servicio de acción de gracias.
With a passage of scripture from the book of Psalms.
Con un pasaje de la escritura del libro de los Salmos.
Give praise to the Lord, proclaim his name, make known among the nations what he has done.
Den gracias al Señor, invoquen su nombre. Den a conocer sus obras entre las naciones.
Sing to him, sing praise to him, tell of all his wonderful acts.
Cántenle, entónenle salmos, hablen de todas sus maravillas.
Glory in his holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice.
Siéntanse orgullosos de su santo nombre. Alégrense el corazón de los que buscan al Señor.
And look to the Lord in his strength. Seek his face always.
Recurran al Señor y a su fuerza. Busquen siempre su rostro.
Remember the wonders he has done, his miracles and the judgments he pronounced.
Recuerden las maravillas que ha realizado, sus señales y los decretos que ha emitido.
The people of Israel sometimes forgot the things that the Lord had done for them.
La gente de Israel a veces había olvidado lo que el Señor hacía por ellos.
And then they would remember and they would give thanks.
Y después ellos recordaban y daban gracias.
And we don't want to forget the blessings of the Lord.
Pero nosotros no queremos olvidar las bendiciones del Señor.
We want to remember him.
Las queremos recordar, las queremos recordar a él y lo que él ha hecho.
And so let's bow together today.
Oremos este día.
Lord, you alone are worthy of our praise.
Señor, tú eres el único que eres honroso, que eres digno de nuestra alabanza.
You deserve our praise, Lord.
Tú lo mereces todo.
And we are here, Father God.
Y estamos aquí, Señor Dios.
We are on time.
Y estamos aquí a tiempo.
And we are ready to worship you.
Y estamos listos para alabarte a ti.
We want to give you thanks.
Te queremos dar gracias.
For so many things.
Por tantas cosas.
And so this service is for your glory.
Entonces este servicio es para tu gloria.
For your honor, Lord.
Para tu honra.
May your name be lifted up.
Que tu nombre sea alzado.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Amen.
Amen.
And I just want to encourage you today.
Y le quiero alentar el día de hoy.
As we are counting our blessings, as we are giving our thanks.
Mientras contamos acerca de nuestras bendiciones y damos gracias.
I just want you to pour your heart out to the Lord and worship him because he alone is worthy of our praise.
Den el corazón al Señor y alábenle porque él es digno de alabanza.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Stand to our feet if you will. The psalmist says, clap your hands unto the Lord. And so let's give him a hand clap of praise as we begin our service today.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Gracias, alabado sea el Señor.
You may be seated.
Pueden tomar asiento.
I'd like for our senior adults and our children that are here, if you are participating today in our Thanksgiving cards, if you'll just come up to the front, Pastor Morgan will meet you over there, senior adults. Sí. And then children, Mickey will meet you over there.
Si pueden venir los adultos mayores y los niños que van a ayudar y van a participar de esto, la van a pedir que se pueden pasar aquí al frente y las pastoras Mickey y Morgan los van a ayudar.
And as our senior adults are coming across the platform with their cards of thanks,
mientras ellos vienen con esas tarjetas de agradecimiento,
we are going to sing an old hymn about counting our blessings.
Vamos a cantar un himno un poco antiguo acerca de lo que es contar nuestras bendiciones.
How many of you are familiar with a hymn called Count Your Blessings?
¿Cuántos de ustedes conocen ese himno de contar las bendiciones?
Good, quite a few of you. So
bien, bueno.
We will sing as our senior adults are counting their blessings. So in just a moment we'll ask for your help as our seniors come across, and then we're going to do the same thing with our children today.
Entonces cantaremos mientras ellos pasan por acá adelante.
Life's billows are you tempest tossed? When you are discouraged, thinking all is lost, count your many blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. Are you ever burdened with a load of care? Does the cross seem heavy you are called to bear? Count your many blessings, every doubt will fly, and you will be singing as the days go by. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. When you look at others with their lands and gold, think that Christ has promised you his wealth untold. Count your many blessings money cannot buy, your reward in heaven and your home on high. Count your blessings, them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. Sing that chorus once again. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. Let's give our senior adults a wonderful round of applause. was blind and now I'm seeing in color. I was dead and now I'm living forever. I had failed, but you were my redeemer. I've been blessed beyond all measure. I was lost, now I'm found by the Father. I've been changed from a ruin to a treasure. I've been given a hope and a future. I've been blessed beyond all.
Thank you.
Amen. Let's give our children a round of applause. At this time, we are going to have some testimonies from people within our congregation. About the gratitude that they have to the Lord for what He's doing in their lives, their hearts,
their hearts.
Hi, I'm Johnny Munaski.
Hola, me llamo Johnny Munaski.
And when Mark asked me to share what I was thankful for, I immediately know what to talk about.
Y cuando me preguntó Mark acerca de qué podía compartir, acerca de mi agradecimiento, yo sabía lo que podía compartir.
I'm from Cleveland, Bedford, Ohio, and I grew up going to Bedford Church of the Nazarene.
Yo soy de Cleveland, de Bedford, Ohio, y me crecí ahí yendo a la iglesia por allá.
A place very close to Mark's heart.
Un lugar cercano al corazón del pastor Mark.
And just looking back, I think about all the people there through youth group and Sunday school.
Mientras pienso acerca de esa gente, pienso acerca de toda la gente que yo vi durante el grupo de niños y del grupo de jóvenes.
They invested in me, they prayed for me, they loved me, and I wouldn't be where I am today without them.
Que invirtieron en mí, me ayudaron y me hicieron quien yo soy ahora.
And I didn't start going to church until about third grade.
Y no comencé a la iglesia hasta que yo estaba como en el tercer grado.
And what it took to get me there was an invitation.
Y lo que lo tomó para que yo me fuera para la iglesia fue una invitación.
Our neighbor growing up invited my mom to church, and she started taking us every Sunday.
Mi vecino invitó a mi madre a la iglesia y ella comenzó a llevarnos a la iglesia cada semana.
And so as I look back and I think about all the people that loved me and prayed for me and invested in my life.
Así que cuando pienso acerca de cómo crecí y tanta gente que invirtió tanto de su tiempo en mi vida.
It all happened because of an invitation.
Todo inició por debido a una invitación.
So there's so many things that I've gone through and learned because of that foundation I had at church.
Hubieron tantas cosas que yo aprendí, tantas cosas que vi debido a esa fundación, ese fundamento, esa base que yo tuve en la iglesia.
And it all happened because our next door neighbor invited us to come.
Y todo pasó porque nuestro vecino de lado nos invitó a venir a la iglesia.
So that is my testimony of gratitude.
Ese es mi agradecimiento.
I had to write mine out.
Yo tuve que escribir el mío.
This is a week where I am always reminded of gratitude.
Esta es una semana donde siempre me recuerdo acerca de lo que es la gratitud.
And God's been teaching me an awful lot about gratitude, especially in the last 2 years.
Y Dios me ha querido enseñar mucho acerca de la gratitud, especialmente en los últimos 2 años.
It was about 2 years ago that our family
hace como 2 años en nuestra familia
was hit with a pretty stormy season of life.
Se nos golpeó con una estación en la vida muy difícil.
And without going into all the detail, we suffered a lot of different kinds of loss.
Y aunque tal vez no sería bueno darles todos los detalles en este momento, nosotros sufrimos muchos tipos de pérdidas.
Including great financial loss, and everything just kind of hit at the same time.
También una pérdida financiera y tantas cosas que solamente llegaron y nos pegaron, nos tocaron al mismo tiempo.
So after living in Wichita, Kansas for 10 years, we decided to move back here to Ohio, closer to family, and just to kind of start over.
Entonces, después de vivir allá por Kansas por ya 10 años, decidimos regresar aquí a Ohio y estar con la familia.
And the Lord has just been teaching me so much.
El Señor me ha enseñado tantas cosas.
He has been stripping away the things that I always thought were so important.
Me ha estado quitando tantas cosas de mi vida que yo creía que eran importantes.
And at one point,
y en un punto,
on one of my hardest days,
en uno de mis días más difíciles,
I remember hearing the Lord say to me,
yo recuerdo que el Señor me dijo,
do you trust me?
¿Me confías? ¿Confías en mí?
And of course, I wanted my answer to be, sure, Lord, I trust you.
Yo quería decir, sí, claro, Señor, yo confío en ti.
And the response was, no, Cheryl, do you trust me? Even in the lousiest of circumstances, even when nothing makes sense.
Y me dijo, ¿tú confías en mí en medio de todas estas circunstancias, aunque nada de esto tiene sentido?
And I had to honestly think about that.
Y tuve que pensar acerca de esto.
And I had to learn to let go of some control.
Y tuve que dejar ir de algunas cosas que yo quería controlar de mi vida.
And God began to remind me that no matter my circumstances, no matter what was going on around me, He was right there.
que no importando las circunstancias, no importando lo que está pasando en mi vida, Él está allí.
He was right there with me right in the middle of the storm.
Él estaba allí conmigo en medio de toda la tormenta.
And I have this note on my desk at work.
Y yo tengo algo en el trabajo.
And my prayers began to change from, Lord, change my circumstances, to, Lord, change me.
Y en mi vida comencé a ver que mis oraciones comenzaban a cambiar, y en lugar de estar pidiendo, Dios, cambia mis circunstancias, yo pedí y decía, Dios, cámbiame a mí.
And my prayer that I began to declare over and over and over was this.
Y la oración que yo continuaba declarando una y otra vez es esta.
I will trust you and I will follow you.
Yo te confío, confío en ti y yo te seguiré a ti.
I will trust you, Lord, and you alone. And I will follow you and you alone.
En ti y solo en ti, y te voy a seguir a ti y solamente a ti.
And then it also became, and I will thank you for the blessings I do have.
Y entonces comenzó a agradecerse por las bendiciones que yo sí tengo.
In the middle of the storm.
En medio de todas las tormentas.
I began to pray more prayers of gratitude, where I focused more on what's going right instead of everything that's going wrong.
Comencé a orar oraciones más de gratitud, donde me enfoqué más acerca de las cosas que están pasando y que son buenas, y no me dejé enfocar en aquellas cosas que estaban pasando y parecían malas.
I began to thank God for my blessings and thank Him ahead of time for however He was going to choose to answer my prayers and whenever He chose to answer them.
Le agradecí a Dios por mis bendiciones y le agradecí de antemano por cualquiera que fuera la manera en la cual Él iba a contestar mis oraciones.
And I can't say I've been perfect at this every day.
Y no he sido perfecta en esto todos los días.
There have been bumpy days.
Han habido días no tan buenos.
And I can't say everything's worked out perfectly, exactly the way I would have orchestrated things.
Y no puedo decir que cada día fue lo que yo estaba pensando que iba a pasar y funcionaron las cosas como yo quería.
But I can say that God's plan is perfect.
Pero puedo decir que el plan de Dios es perfecto.
And that He's changing me.
Y Él me está cambiando a mí.
And making me stronger and taking my faith out into the deep. And He's making my family stronger.
Y me estaba fortaleciendo, he llevado a mi fe mucho más a un nivel más profundo y he fortalecido a mi familia.
Because of the valley, because of the storm, I'm thankful.
Debido a la tormenta, debido a aquel valle de sombras.
So I will trust you, I will follow you, and I will thank you for the blessings I do have.
Entonces, Señor, yo confío en ti, yo te seguiré a ti, y yo te agradezco y te agradeceré por las bendiciones que tú das.
And I pray that's your prayer too today.
Y mi oración es que esa sea su oración el día de hoy.
Let's stand together as we join in worshiping the Lord and giving Him thanks in song.
Pongamos de pie mientras nos unimos a alabar al Señor en canción.
Oh, praise the name of the Lord our God. Oh, praise His name forevermore. For endless days we will sing Your praise. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord our God. Jesus bled and died for me. I see His wounds, His hands, it's me, my Savior on that cursed tree. Turn to wind, O Lord, and listen. return in robes of white. The blazing sun shall pierce the night, and I will rise among the saints, my gaze transfixed on Jesus'
Let's just lift our voices, just the congregation.
Cantemos juntos, sola congregación.
Lift our voices. If you feel comfortable today, lift your hands. And your voices and your hearts.
Es nuestras manos.
God, we transcend time and space today.
Trascendemos el tiempo y el espacio el día de hoy, Señor.
As we worship those who are in eternity with you, Father God.
Mientras alabamos a aquellos que están en la eternidad contigo.
We lift up your holy name.
Alzamos tu santísimo nombre.
And we worship you, Father God.
Te alabamos, Señor, nuestro Dios.
And we give you thanks today, Father.
Te damos las gracias.
For your incredible love,
por tu amor tan maravilloso,
your incredible grace that we do not deserve,
tu gracia tan maravillosa que no merecemos.
We pour out our hearts in praise to you today, Lord.
Damos nuestros corazones en alabanza a ti hoy.
Because it's you that are worthy of our praise.
Porque eres tú el digno de toda alabanza.
Through all eternity, we give you praise.
Por toda la eternidad te alabamos.
In the name of Jesus.
En nombre de Jesús.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Te agradecemos, Señor Jesús,
for your powerful name.
Por tu nombre tan poderoso.
And the power that comes in that name, Lord.
El poder que viene por medio de tu nombre.
Sing this together, cantamos.
Cantemos juntos.
Us in prayer this morning.
Mientras oramos esta mañana,
you may want to come and just kneel at the altar and give God thanks. Or maybe you're carrying a burden today and you want to come and bow before Him. As we go to prayer today, let's just come and kneel if we would like to and pray to Him today.
Oremos hoy, arrodillémonos si queramos, pero oremos.
As we pray this morning, I want to read this verse for us.
Les quiero leer este pasaje, este versículo hoy mientras oramos.
In 1 Thessalonians 5, verses 16 through 18.
En 1 Tesalonicenses 5, versículo del 16 al 18.
It says, rejoice always.
Dice, regocijémonos en todo tiempo.
Pray continually.
Oremos sin cesar.
Give thanks in all circumstances.
Agradezcamos en todas las circunstancias.
For this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus.
Porque este es el deseo de Dios para ustedes en Cristo Jesús.
Let's pray this morning.
Oremos hoy.
Dear Heavenly Father, we're here today.
Señor de los cielos, estamos ante ti hoy.
Just as a thankful people.
Como una gente agradecida.
Just the different ways that we see you work in our lives.
Por las maneras en que te hemos visto que tú trabajas en nuestras vidas.
And dear Heavenly Father, you, in all of our different hearts and minds today.
Y Señor, en todos nuestros corazones y mentes el día de hoy.
There are just many different things that we're thankful for.
En tantas diferentes cosas por las cuales estamos agradecidos.
We saw those on those signs today, dear Jesus.
Miramos aquellas cosas, aquellas señales, aquellas pancartas del día de hoy.
Because we are thankful for Jesus.
Porque estamos agradecidos por ti.
For you sending your Son to die on the cross for our sins.
Porque mandaste a tu hijo Jesús a morir en la cruz por nosotros.
We're thankful for things like health and family.
Estamos agradecidos por la salud, por la familia.
And kids.
Niños.
But dear Father, we're also thankful today for horses and ice cream.
Pero Señor, también estamos agradecidos por los caballitos y por el helado.
Because they're important to our kids.
Porque son importantes para nuestros niños.
Because you love us, you give us these things.
Porque nos amas, tú nos das cosas.
That sometimes that we overlook.
Aquí hay cosas que a veces no olvidamos de ellas.
And today in the service, dear Heavenly Father, as we reflect.
Este día en servicio, Señor, mientras reflexionamos.
May we be thankful for Jesus.
Que estemos agradecidos por Jesús.
And may we be thankful for ice cream.
Y que estemos agradecidos por lo que tú has hecho en nuestras vidas.
Because you love us.
Porque, Señor, tú nos amas.
You love each and every one of us.
A cada uno de nosotros nos amas.
For who we are.
Por quienes somos.
No matter where we're at today.
No importa dónde estemos hoy.
Or the circumstances that we're in.
Las circunstancias en las que estemos.
You love each and every one of us.
A cada uno de nosotros tú nos amas.
Dearing Father, I just ask you to draw us closer to you.
Acércanos a ti.
That you speak to our hearts today.
Y habla a nuestros corazones.
And we may we always be reminded.
Que siempre seamos recordados.
About how thankful that we are.
De la manera en la cual estamos tan agradecidos.
Thank you, Jesus.
Te agradecemos, Jesús.
In your precious name.
En tu nombre precioso.
Amen.
Amen.
Good morning.
Buenos días.
We're glad that you're here worshiping with us today.
Estamos alegres de que estén aquí adorando con nosotros.
I want to welcome you today.
Les doy la bienvenida.
I want to remind you, if you haven't smelled it yet,
si no lo han recordado, si no lo huelen todavía,
that we're having a Thanksgiving dinner after the church or after the service.
Después de aquí vamos a tener un almuerzo de acción de gracias.
And it's for each and every one of you here today.
Es para todos los que están por acá.
Also, this week, because of Thanksgiving, we won't be having any Wednesday night ministries.
Debido a lo que es el día de acción de gracias esta semana, no vamos a tener ningún ministerio el día miércoles.
And next Saturday, we're having a fall outside cleanup day here at the church from 9 to noon.
Y el siguiente sábado vamos a tener un día de limpieza aquí en la iglesia desde las 9 de la mañana a las 12 p.m. para quien quiera venir.
And then that will give you a chance to come and work and sweat a little bit for the big game next week.
Va a poder usted venir a trabajar por acá y sudar un poco antes de que llegue el juego de la siguiente semana.
So I'd like to invite you all to come out and help us work outside here at the church and do a little cleanup.
A todos que vengan aquí a ayudarnos a limpiar un poco la iglesia.
This is the and then the Wednesday after that.
Y después el miércoles después de ese.
The church will be decorating the foyer and the sanctuary.
La iglesia va a estar decorando lo que es el santuario y también el vestíbulo de afuera.
It's going to be on a Wednesday night, and if you come and be part of that, there'll be pizza and Christmas trees to be put together.
Va a ser un miércoles por la noche. Si quieren venir, va a haber pizza, va a haber unos cuantos árboles de Navidad.
And it's a great time to be together.
Y es un buen momento para estar juntos.
This is time of our service where we take our tithes and offerings. I want to invite the ushers to come forward at this time.
En este momento pedimos los diezmos y las ofrendas, y le invito a los ujieres que pasen adelante.
Each week they pass out a black booklet that we ask that you sign and pass down your aisle.
Cada semana ellos pasan un librito negro que les pido que ustedes lo firmen y lo pasen por su fila.
Once it gets to the end or beside you, you can just set it down beside you.
Y cuando llegue al fin de la fila, por favor póngalo a su lado.
I'm going to remind you that you can always give online here at the church as we pass the baskets.
Les quiero recordar que usted siempre puede dar en línea aquí en la iglesia mientras se pasan las canastas.
But let's pray for our offering this morning.
Pero oremos por las ofrendas hoy.
Dear Jesus, as we pray for our tithes and offerings today,
Señor Jesús, oramos por los diezmos y las ofrendas.
I'm sure there's lots of people here that are thankful for finances.
Yo creo que hay mucha gente aquí que está agradecida por las finanzas.
And the ways that you provide for each and every one of us.
Por como tú provees para cada uno de nosotros.
May we be generous with the things that you've given us.
Que seamos agradecidos por aquellas cosas que tú nos das.
May we be cheerful as we give back to you, dearing Father.
Y que nos regocijemos porque tú nos has dado a nosotros, Señor.
We thank you for the things that you do for this church.
Te agradecemos por las cosas que tú has dado a esta iglesia.
And the ministry opportunities that we have.
Y todas las oportunidades de ministerio que tenemos.
Please bless our tithes and offerings today.
Bendice nuestros diezmos y ofrendas el día de hoy.
In your name.
En tu nombre.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
like to ask Pastor Morgan and Pastor Mickey just to join us on the platform for just a moment. We have so many different events and activities and ministries that are taking place in this church. But we rarely are able to update you and share with you about those events or those activities.
Pero muchas veces no les podemos compartir acerca de lo que pasa con esas actividades o el resultado de esas actividades.
So each staff member is just going to share briefly about one of our activities in case you were not able to be a part of that.
Entonces cada uno de nuestros miembros de nuestro staff va a venir a compartir un poco de las actividades por si acaso no pudieron ser parte de ellas.
And we just want to give God praise for those different ministries and things that are taking place.
Y vamos a darle gracias a Dios por esos ministerios y tantas cosas que están pasando.
And you start, Edward.
Y yo empiezo.
But I will not translate for you.
Pero no me va a traducir.
You speak too fast in both languages.
Hablo demasiado rápido en ambas lenguas. So then we had an event here. I'm going to try to speak a little slower. So we had an event here. It was an immigration Know Your Rights training. Tuvimos un evento aquí en la iglesia, lo que fue un evento de entrenamiento para personas inmigrantes. In that event, we were helping people to know some of their rights as immigrants. En ese evento pudimos ayudar a diferentes personas a conocer un poco de sus derechos como inmigrantes. We had 32 people, and out of those 32 people, we had all the pastors of the Columbus area of the Church of the Nazarene. Tuvimos 32 personas, y entre las 32 personas tuvimos a todos los pastores del área de Columbus de la Iglesia del Nazareno. A lot of people were able to be helped. Muchas personas pudieron ser ayudadas, and we got enough resources to keep on helping people in our congregations for the next year. Y tuvimos suficientes recursos para poder seguir ayudando a personas en nuestras congregaciones por el siguiente año. So we give thanks to God for that. Así que le agradecemos a Dios por eso.
So I'll be sharing a little bit about the youth ministry.
Voy a compartir un poco acerca del ministerio de adolescentes.
But more specifically about our fall retreat that we just had a couple weeks ago.
Pero más específico un poquito acerca del el retiro de otoño que tuvimos hace unas cuantas semanas.
Every year at fall retreat on Sunday, we do kind of a testimony service.
Durante nuestro retiro de otoño tenemos un tiempo de testimonios.
And it's cool because all weekend you're just kind of sitting back watching and thinking, okay, God, what are you doing?
Y es muy interesante porque resulta que muchas veces durante la semana quedamos viendo y decimos, Dios, ¿qué es lo que tú vas a hacer?
Because you never fully know what's going on inside people's minds.
Porque no podemos muchas veces saber lo que pasa en las mentes de las diferentes personas.
And so that time on Sunday in that space is where we kind of get to see what God's been doing all weekend.
Entonces durante ese tiempo el domingo cuando tenemos ese retiro miramos lo que Dios está haciendo.
And this year there were two main themes that kind of popped up that were shared.
Y hubo dos temas específicos que los adolescentes estuvieron compartiendo.
One was that people knew that they were loved by God.
Uno era que la gente, los adolescentes, se dieron cuenta de que ellos eran amados por Dios.
And that was shared in different forms of, I know that He's not disappointed in me.
Y eso fue compartido de maneras diferentes porque se dieron cuenta y dijeron, yo sé que Él no está avergonzado de mí.
I know that God hasn't stopped loving me.
Yo sé que Dios no me ha parado de amar.
That I'm God's daughter or son.
Pero yo soy el hijo o la hija de Dios.
That I'm not a burden to Him.
No soy una carga para Dios.
And so many people shared just the simple truth that God loves them.
Pero tanta gente pudo compartir la verdad tan sencilla de que Dios les ama.
And the other main theme that was shared was about busyness.
Y lo otro que fue compartido fue acerca de la ocupación, qué tan ocupados estamos.
And even from a young age, our teens know what it's like to be busy and have a lot of things going on.
E incluso desde una edad muy muy temprana nuestros adolescentes se dieron cuenta de lo que significa estar muy ocupados.
And they shared how much they needed that space to just get away and be still for a second.
Y compartieron de cuánto necesitan ese tiempo para simplemente relajarse, descansar y estar tranquilos por un momento.
And just to have space to hear God.
Y de obtener un poquito de tiempo para así escuchar a Dios.
And space to have fun with one another.
Y espacio para así poder divertirse los unos con los otros.
And so I just want to give praise that of all the things our teens could walk away knowing from that weekend.
Y yo quiero que demos gracias a Dios por ese momento que nuestros adolescentes pasaron en ese retiro.
They walked away knowing that God loves them.
Porque salieron de ese retiro sabiendo de que Dios les ama.
And that church is a space where they can come together and be still, but also have fun.
Y que la iglesia es un lugar donde ellos pueden estar tranquilos, pueden estar bien y se pueden divertir.
And have good relationships that are life-giving and good.
Y pueden tener buenas relaciones, las cuales son dadoras de vida y son buenas.
So I give thanks for that.
Yo estoy agradecida por eso.
And that's a little bit of how fall retreat went.
Y eso es un poquito acerca del retiro de otoño.
And up next, Mickey's going to share from the children's side.
Y ahora la pastora Mickey va a compartir del lado de los niños.
I'm Pastor Mickey.
Yo soy la pastora Mickey.
I'm going to share about Monster Mash.
Yo voy a compartir acerca del evento Monster Mash.
That happened on October 31st.
Ese pasó el 31 de octubre.
Halloween night.
En la noche de Halloween.
Which was extremely rainy this year.
La cual fue muy lluviosa este año.
The past 2 years we've had this.
Los últimos dos años que hemos tenido esto.
Something has always happened that made me remember that God is in control of all of it.
Algo siempre ha pasado que me hace recordar que Dios tiene el control sobre las cosas.
The first year it was the cold.
El primer año fue el frío.
And then this past year it was the rain.
Y después este año fue la lluvia.
So we had 460 people inside our foyer.
Tuvimos 460 personas en nuestro vestíbulo.
It was an amazing outreach event for us.
Fue un gran evento de alcance para nuestra iglesia.
But it was also amazing for our church family to come together and work with us.
Pero también fue bonito para nuestra iglesia como familia que se uniera para así hacer algo bonito.
We had 40 volunteers from our church help.
Tuvimos 40 voluntarios de nuestra iglesia que ayudaron.
And I just want to thank you guys for all helping with candy. Oh, sorry.
Y les quiero ayudar, les agradecer a ustedes por cómo todos ustedes ayudaron con el dulce.
With the food.
Con la comida.
And just with showing up to help me.
Y simplemente con mostrar estar ahí para ayudarnos.
So I give thanks to God for Monster Mash and for you all.
Entonces le doy gracias a Dios por este evento que tuvimos y por todos ustedes.
And we have a video that Cheryl Sharps put together for us.
Y tenemos un video que Cheryl Sharps puso junto el que hizo para nosotros.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. My love Notari in the castle east, to the master bedroom where the vampires feast. The ghouls all came from their humble abodes to catch a jolt from my electrodes.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash. Zombies were having fun. The party had just begun. The guests included Wolfman, Dracula, and his son. The scene was rocking, though we're digging the sounds. He got on chains backed by his baying hounds. The coffin bangers were about to arrive with their vocal group, the Crypt Kicker Five. They played the monster mash.
The monster mash.
And it was a graveyard smash.
They played the mash.
It's caught on in a flash.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash.
Wow.
Out from his coffin, Drac's voice did ring.
Wow.
Seems he was troubled by just one thing.
Wow.
Opened the lid and shook his fist and said,
wow.
Whatever happened to my Transylvania twist?
It's now the mash.
It's now the monster mash. It's now a graveyard smash.
It's now the mash.
It's caught on in a flash.
It's now the mash.
It's now the monster mash.
Wow.
Now everything's cool, Drac's a part of the band.
Wow.
And my monster mash is the hit of the land.
Wow.
For you, the living, this mash was meant to.
Wow.
When you get to my door, tell them Boris sent.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash. And do my graveyard smash.
Then you can mash.
You'll catch on with a flash.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.
Mash fool!
Easy, Igor, you impetuous young boy.
Mash fool!
Abby. Happy Thanksgiving. This Thanksgiving, I'm really thankful for all the opportunities I've gotten to have this year, like the DR trip and my fashion show and a lot of other things that have just been so fun this year.
I am thankful for my brother and my family.
Muy buenos días, mi nombre es Raquel Ríos. Estoy aquí para contar el testimonio de vida y agradecimiento que Dios ha hecho en mi vida. Bueno, en realidad Dios ha hecho muchas cosas en mi vida, pero la más importante creo yo fue hace unos 6 años, cuando 2 meses antes de casarme me dio un derrame cerebral, un aneurisma, la cual me dejó muy mal y los doctores decían que yo ya no tenía esperanzas para vivir. Pero gracias a la oración de mucha gente, Dios me devolvió la vida. Permitió que un doctor que era muy reconocido en mi país me operara. Y después de la operación estuve en reposo 1 mes dentro de casa y me recuperé rápido, gracias a Dios. Hasta los mismos doctores se sorprendieron de que mi recuperación fuera tan rápida y que no haya quedado secuelas de este derrame, de este aneurisma. Y yo muy agradecida con Dios porque me dio otra vez la vida y porque después de esto me pude casar. A la fecha, así toda pelada, sin cabello, me pude casar y fue todo muy bonito. Luego de un cierto tiempo pude tener mi niña, pude tener mis 2 hijitos que están ahorita aquí asistiendo a la iglesia dominical. Y muy contenta y muy agradecida con Dios porque ha hecho tantas cosas en mi vida. Esta es una de las más importantes, que me dio la vida otra vez. Después de casarme, después de 5 años de casada, no podía tampoco embarazarme. Y yo me sentía muy triste y lloraba siempre porque yo ya quería tener un bebé. Pero también en el amor de Dios, logré embarazarme así de la nada, sin esperarlo, de un momento a otro. Y pude tener a mi primera hija y 2 años después también embarazarme de mi segundo hijito. Y son los niños más hermosos del mundo, los amo mucho, los quiero e intento darles siempre lo mejor, mostrarles siempre el amor de Dios. Gracias por todo esto, Dios me ha enseñado que es lo más importante en mi vida. Y muy agradecida con el Señor por todas las cosas que ha hecho, porque también puedo estar aquí con mi esposo. Él viajaba siempre y nos dejaba allá en mi país, Perú. Pero después de un tiempo salieron todos los papeles y estamos bien aquí, ¿no? En este país y sirviendo acá en esta iglesia, ¿no? En el amor de Dios. Muy agradecida con todo y ese es mi testimonio de agradecimiento a Dios por estas fiestas. Gracias.
I am thankful for all my friends. Tengo gracias para todos mis amigos.
Hi, I'm Emily Preston. Happy Thanksgiving. There's so much to be thankful for this great holiday. After visiting the Dominican Republic, I thank God every time I wake up in a nice warm bed. I also thank Him every time I wake up when I'm healthy enough to do the things I love to do. I also praise Him for things I never thought I'd have to be thankful for, such as plumbing. God has provided me with so much. He has proved time and time again that He will never forsake me, and He always answers my prayers eventually on His time and doesn't leave me wondering what His plan is for me. I think about these things every day, but they become especially prominent during this holiday. And I know things can get crazy around Thanksgiving and Christmas, but it's just that much more important that we make time for God and we slow down and praise Him. So this Thanksgiving and going forward, just make sure to make time and space for God and thank Him for everything He's doing in your lives.
Hi, my name's Weston. I'm 13 years old, and I'm talking about how God has shown me people in my life that are always going to be there for me. A few months ago, my wrestling coach was arrested for child pornography charges, and it hit everyone pretty hard. It showed me that my youth group is just like my family. My football team is always going to be there, and that people are always going to be there. I'm thankful to God because it showed me the people that will always be there and will never bail out on me when things get hard.
I'm thankful for my mom, dad, and brother.
Hey, I'm Natalie, and I've been coming to this church for 1.5 years. So I'm just thankful for the season of life that I'm in right now. I think a lot of times we search for more in life and aren't just content where we are. And so that's something that I'm really trying to focus on. And I'm just really thankful for where God has me right now. And just what he's doing in my life. A year ago, well, I guess a year and a half ago, so the summer of 2017, after I graduated, I moved to Columbus. And that was something that was really difficult for me, just because, like, I am a big family person, and my family's 3 hours away, and so I really just miss them, and I was really just struggling with being here in Columbus and away from them, and kind of just everything that was going on. And I didn't see why God had me here. Like, I didn't understand why I was here. I was really wondering if I should go back home and all these different things. And I just wasn't content in trusting God, to where I was. But fast forward a year and a half, I understand, God has me here for a reason. I don't quite know what that is yet. But I'm thankful that I did end up here in Columbus, and I'm thankful for all that I've learned. I've grown, grew so much in the past year and a half, not only in my faith, but just in every single way that I can think of. I'm very thankful for the Westfield Church of the Nazarene, and for that being one of the main reasons why I've grown so much in my faith, and for people who have reached out to me. I'm very thankful for the Leffer family and for Pastor Mickey and her family. They basically have adopted me. I feel like I'm part of the Schaefer family. But I just know that God has me here for a reason, and I'm thankful for that and for kind of the season of the unknown that I'm in, and just the fact that I have to trust and fully rely on God in order to see what my next steps are, but I'm okay with that. And there is lyrics from a song that I have like really focused on that kind of go with this, and it says, "So I'll stop searching for the answers, I'll stop praying for an escape, and I'll trust you, God, with where I am, and believe that you will have your way." And then it just goes on to say, "Just have your way." So that's kind of where I am right now, is just trusting God that he will have his way. But I'm really, really thankful that that is where I am, and that God is showing me the way each and every day.
I'm thankful for ice cream. Yo tengo gracias para helado.
Hi, my name is Alex Smith. I have been coming to Westerville Naz for 3 years now. I would like to thank God for bringing me to Westerville Nazarene Church, especially in a time in my life where I needed it the most. Since coming here, I have been welcomed by an amazing community that not only lifts me up spiritually, but also personally. I've become more confident, I've made more friends, and I've been able to better serve the Lord now more than ever. Thank you.
Hola a todos.
I'm Julia Trotty.
Yo soy Julia Trotty.
I am a teen here at Westerville Naz.
Yo soy una adolescente aquí en la iglesia.
And if you are a teen or you know a teen,
y si sabes un adolescente o eres un adolescente,
you should definitely come to youth group Thursday nights. We're over there mostly.
De venir el grupo de jóvenes que está por allá.
Yeah. But when Morgan asked me to do this, or to say what I was thankful for,
cuando Morgan me pidió que dijera las cosas por las cuales soy agradecida,
I said, sure, why not? How hard could it be?
¿Por qué no? ¿Qué tan difícil puede ser?
And so I started listing all the things that I was thankful for.
Entonces empecé a listar todas las cosas por las cuales estoy agradecida.
My family, my friends, God's pursuit of me.
Mi familia, mis amigos, cómo Dios me persiguió y me encontró.
And it took me a second to realize how superficially I really thought about those things.
Y después dije yo, ¿qué tan superficial? ¿Qué estas cosas son demasiado superficiales?
I realized that when I gave thanks to God,
Me di cuenta de cuando doy gracias a Dios.
I never actually took the time to truly thank him from the bottom of my heart.
No le di tiempo para de verdad darle gracias desde el fondo de mi corazón.
For all of those things that he has done for me.
Por todas aquellas cosas que él hizo por mí.
And it's really difficult.
Y es difícil.
For me to be humble sometimes.
El ser humilde.
And truly give thanks to him for all that he's done.
Y en realidad darle gracias a él por todas las cosas que él ha hecho.
Because sometimes I think that those things are too small.
Porque a veces yo creo que esas cosas son demasiado chiquitas.
And I know I'm not the only one who struggles with that.
Yo sé que no soy la única que lucha con eso.
So I was reading through my notebook.
Entonces estaba leyendo un cuaderno que yo tengo.
And I was trying to find a moment when I was just truly intimate with God.
Y quería encontrar un momento donde solamente estaba yo en la intimidad con Dios.
And I found this letter that I wrote to him not too long ago.
Y le encontré esta carta que yo le escribí a Dios no hace mucho tiempo.
And I'm going to read it for you guys right
y
now.
Y se la voy a leer un poco.
It says, Dear God.
Y dice, querido Dios.
Your love is truly unfailing and authentic and unconditional.
Tu amor es en realidad uno que nunca falla, uno que es auténtico, uno que nunca me deja.
It is such an incredible thing to think about.
Es una cosa increíble pensar en este amor.
God, you looked at me, at all of mankind.
Tú, Señor, me viste a mí y viste a toda la humanidad.
You saw us at our very worst.
Nos viste en lo peor de nosotros.
And you said, I love you more than everything else in the entire universe.
Y dijiste, yo te amo, yo les amo más que todo el universo.
And I will do anything and everything, including sacrifice myself in your place.
Y yo haré todo, incluso sacrificarme a mí mismo en tu lugar.
Just to be with you.
Solamente para estar con ustedes.
God, you see all of the wounds in my heart.
Dios, tú ves todos los dolores en mi corazón.
The parts I'm ashamed of.
Aquellas cosas de las cuales yo estoy avergonzada.
And your love overwhelms them and heals them.
E incluso tu amor los abruma todo esto.
You're not afraid or disgusted by them.
Y tú no tienes miedo de entrar y ayudarme en estas cosas.
And instead you ask me to stop hiding them from you.
En lugar de esto tú me llamas a dejar de huir de ti.
And release them and surrender them to you.
Y que tú me dejes ser abrazada por tu amor, ser rodeada por tu amor.
Thank you that your love is unconditional and faithful and powerful.
Te agradezco porque tu amor es poderoso, incondicional y nunca falla.
And truly genuine.
Y porque es genuino en realidad.
Thank you, Jesus, that your love heals every wound, no matter how gruesome or shameful it might seem to me.
Gracias, Jesús, porque tu amor sana toda herida, no importando qué tan vergonzosa parezca que es la herida.
And your love is so intimate.
Y tu amor es tan íntimo.
It goes straight to the core of my heart.
Que va hasta lo más profundo de mi corazón.
It penetrates every wall.
Penetra cada pared.
Because nothing can separate me from your love.
Porque nada me puede separar de tu amor.
Thank you, Lord.
Gracias, Dios.
Your beloved, Julia.
Tu amada, Julia.
And I realize that God is so intimate with us.
Y me doy cuenta que Dios es tan íntimo para con nosotros.
Even though I take for granted so much that he does for me.
Aunque yo tomo muchas cosas como que si fueran nada.
He cuts to the very core of my heart.
Él llega hasta lo más profundo de mi corazón.
And this Thanksgiving.
Y este día de acción de gracias.
I just want to thank God for not being superficial with me.
Le doy gracias a Dios porque él no es superficial conmigo.
But for being authentic and real.
Pero porque es auténtico, es real.
All year long.
Siempre, todo el tiempo.
Thank you.
Gracias.
Hello.
Hola, hola.
My name is Sherry Diaz.
Yo me llamo Sherry Diaz.
And I am very thankful.
Y estoy muy agradecida.
When I was asked to do this, I couldn't decide where to start.
Cuando me pidieron hacer esto, yo no sabía por dónde iniciar.
I'm thankful to be born in this country.
Yo estoy agradecida por nacer en este país.
I'm thankful that my parents were raised in the church.
Yo estoy agradecida de que mis padres fueron criados en la iglesia.
I'm thankful they got married and had my older sister.
Yo estoy agradecida de que ellos se casaron y tuvieron a mi hermana mayor.
Because she looked out for me my entire life and still does.
Porque ella me cuidó toda mi vida y todavía me está cuidando.
The best aunt on the planet.
La mejor tía en el mundo.
Estoy agradecido mucho, mucho que me fui a Arizona para estudiar.
I'm also very thankful because I went to Arizona to study.
En Arizona encontré mi esposo.
In Arizona, I found my husband.
Eric.
Eric.
Quien amo mucho.
Who loved me so much.
Y con él tengo los cuatro niños más bellos del mundo.
And I love so much. And with him, I have the four most beautiful children in the world.
Y toda su familia, sus hermanas, su mamá que viene aquí para vivir con nosotros.
And all his family, his sisters, his mom that is here living with us.
Abrió mi vida y la vida de toda mi familia.
They opened my life and the life of all my family.
Estoy muy agradecida de encontrar esa iglesia.
I am very thankful that we were able to find this church.
En esa iglesia, mi relación con Dios.
It was in this church that my relationship with God.
Convirtió bilingüe.
Sí, became bilingual.
Como muchas de las relaciones de mi vida que son tan especiales.
Just as many other relationships in my life that are so special.
Estoy muy muy agradecida por tantas cosas de mi vida.
I am very thankful for so many things in my life.
I want to also give special thanks today.
Y también le quiero una gracia especial, un agradecimiento especial.
For the life of my father.
Por la vida de mi padre.
For those that don't know, he passed on September 24th this year.
Para aquellos que no sabían, él se fue con el Señor el 24 de septiembre de este año.
He was the best.
Él era el mejor.
He was smart.
Inteligente.
Strong.
Fuerte.
Ordinary.
Muy molestoso.
Silly.
Un poquito, era juguetón.
And if he loved you,
y si él te amaba,
you knew you were loved.
Tú sabías que tú eras amado.
He was a teacher.
Él era un maestro.
An athletic director.
Un director atlético.
A coach.
Un entrenador.
In Springfield, Ohio.
In Springfield, Ohio.
He was my coach.
Él era mi entrenador.
He coached generations of families in Springfield, Ohio.
Entrenó a muchas generaciones de familias allá en Springfield, Ohio.
He didn't go to church a lot.
No fue mucho a la iglesia.
Because he was so busy working in other people's lives to help them.
Porque estaba tan ocupado trabajando en la vida de otras personas para así ayudarles.
And for me, looking, reflecting on his life.
Y para mí, mientras yo reflexiono y miro su vida.
It's amazing to see how much wonderful work of the Lord's my dad was able to do with his 72 years on this.
Ver cómo es posible que mi padre hizo tantas cosas para el trabajo del Señor en sus 72 años que él vivió.
We miss him dearly.
Le extrañamos mucho.
Today I give thanks for all of these things and especially for the life of my father.
Yo hoy doy gracias por todas estas cosas, especialmente por la vida de mi padre.
Gracias.
Thank you.
To the hero and the coward, to the prisoner and the soldier, to the young and to the older, all who hunger, all who thirst, all the last and all the first, all the paupers and the princes, all who failed, you've been forgiven, all who dream and all who suffer, all who loved and lost another, all the chained and all the free, all who follow, all who lead, anyone who's been mentored, all the lost who have been found, all who've been labeled right or wrong, to everyone who hears this song.
In just a moment, we're going to dismiss and go to the table of food that is prepared for us.
En un momento vamos a dejar que todos salgan y puedan ir a la mesa que está preparada por nosotros, aquí a la mesa de comida.
But before we do that this morning,
pero antes de hacer eso esta mañana,
we want to remember the spiritual table.
Queremos recordar aquí a mesa espiritual.
And I'm going to ask Pastor Jeremy and Morgan and Mickey, pastors, if they'll come forward.
Y voy a pedir a los pastores, Jeremy, Morgan y Mickey que pasen para adelante.
In just a moment, we are going to remember.
Y un momento recordaremos.
Remember the Lord Jesus Christ and what He's done for us.
A nuestro Señor Jesucristo, lo que Él hizo por nosotros.
Through His broken body, which is represented by the physical bread.
Por medio de su cuerpo quebrantado, que es representado por un pan físico.
Through the blood that was shed,
aquella sangre, por medio de aquella sangre que fue derramada,
which is represented by the physical juice,
que es representada por aquel jugo físico.
And we are going to remember.
Y vamos a recordar.
We don't want to be like the people of Israel who constantly forgot the blessings of the Lord.
No queremos ser como el pueblo de Israel que constantemente olvidaron las bendiciones del Señor.
And Jesus helped us with this.
Y Jesús nos ayudó con esto.
By giving us a command.
Dándonos un mandamiento.
To do this whenever we eat of it.
Un mandato para que hiciéramos esto mientras tomemos de esta comida.
And whenever we drink of it.
Y cada vez que tomemos de este jugo.
To give thanks.
De esta manera dar gracias.
And so I'm just going to invite you at this time, if you will, just to stand and come to one of the front areas here. Take a piece of bread and dip that into the juice.
Entonces le invitamos que se ponga de pie y venga aquí para la parte de adelante y tome un parte de esta Santa Cena, que tome el pan y después lo hunda en el jugo.
And do that with a thankful heart today.
Y lo haga esto hoy con un corazón agradecido.
If you need gluten free, we have that in the back also.
Si usted necesita un pan libre de gluten, está por allá atrás.
On the night the Lord Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and broke it and gave thanks.
Cuando nuestro Señor Jesucristo, aquí anoche donde él fue, cuando él se entregó así por nosotros, él vino y tomó el pan y lo quebró y dio gracias.
And said, "This is my body which is broken for you."
Y dijo, "Este es mi cuerpo que fue quebrantado por ti."
The apostle Paul told the church in Corinth.
El apóstol Pablo le dijo a la iglesia en Corinto.
That after dinner he took the cup.
Que después de la cena él tomó la copa.
Saying, "This is the new covenant in my blood."
Diciendo, "Este es el nuevo pacto en mi sangre."
Do this whenever you drink it.
Haz esto cada vez que tú tomes de este vino.
In remembrance of me.
En recordatorio de mí.
And so as you partake today of the bread and the cup.
Entonces mientras usted toma parte de lo que es el pan y también la copa que tiene jugo de uva.
I ask that you would do that with a thankful heart.
Haz esto con un corazón agradecido.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Been
all start on the outside, the outside looking in. This is where grace begins. We were hungry, we were thirsty, with nothing left to give. Oh, the shape that we were in. And just when all hope seemed lost, love opened the door for us. He said, come to the table, come join the sinners who have been redeemed. Take your place beside the Savior. Sit down and be set free. Come to the table.
Thank you, Lord Jesus, for the invitation to your banquet table.
Te agradecemos, Señor Jesús, por la invitación que tú nos has dado a tu mesa, a tu banquete.
We thank you for your salvation that you provided to us.
Te agradecemos por la salvación que tú has proveído para nosotros.
Through your broken body and your shed blood.
Por medio de tu cuerpo quebrantado y tu sangre que fue derramada.
And we thank you also, Lord, for the physical feast that has been prepared for us today.
También te agradecemos por ese festín también físico que ha sido preparado para nosotros hoy.
May you bless the food.
Que tú bendigas la comida.
May you bless the fellowship, Lord.
Y que tú también bendigas el compañerismo.
And thank you for those who have been working to prepare this for us today.
Y te agradecemos por aquellos que han estado preparando esto el día de hoy.
We truly give you thanks.
Te agradecemos.
In the name of Jesus.
En nombre de Jesús.
And all of God's people said,
y el pueblo
amen.
Dice, amen.
Amen. God bless you. You are dismissed and the food is ready. So go straight out and get some Thanksgiving food today.
La comida está lista. Pueden ir a comer por allá.